Hello everybody, this video will be about liquidity index and how we can use it to classify the consistency of fine-grained soil. So for this type of soil we typically have some plasticity. You will see that the formula that we use for liquidity index, it includes liquid limit and plastic limit. And also we would like to look at the water content in situ. So this is natural water content. And basically what we do with this particular case, if we have, for example, here plastic limit and here we have liquid limit, usually we have natural water content of soil somewhere in between. So in this case, we're gonna see if it's closer to the liquid limit or closer to the plastic limit, right? And based on the position of the natural water content, then we'll decide if this is plastic soil, so it will act like plastic solids if shared, or is going to be a viscous liquid. So in this case, probably for this particular case, you will see that water content will be very high, maybe probably even higher than liquid limit. And for this particular case, when we have brittle fracture, if shear, so this will be probably more on the dry side of the soil, so it will act more like, I don't know, like maybe like a rock. So because brittle failure is common for rocks or something harder. So usually what we do in the field, we just collect soil samples from the field and we can measure a natural water content of that soil in situ. Then we can conduct algebraic limits tests to get liquid limit and plastic limit. And then we just put it in the formula to estimate liquidity index. And then we're going to look what number we have to classify the soil. But I would like to have a slightly different example just to have a little bit of more fun. So in this case, we are already given data of liquid limit of the soil. It's very high, 85%. And plastic limit is 28%. And we're also already given the liquidity index, which is 0.2. So we kind of need to work it backward and estimate the natural water content of the soil, so W, right? So let's see how we're gonna solve it. We're going to use the formula. We just rearrange it as water content minus plastic limit. Will be equal plasticity index times liquidity index, right? So then we can rewrite it as water content minus plastic limit is 28, right? And then plasticity index is the difference between liquid limit and plastic limit. It's 85 minus 28. And then we're going to multiply it by 0.2. Correct? So in this case, we'll see that water content will be equal. So this should be around 11.4 plus 28. That will give us a value of 39.4%. So what we get from this exercise, we estimated the natural water content. So this is 39.4%. So I'm talking about this value here. Okay, so that's how it is used. Not that difficult, pretty straightforward. It just, we need to know natural water content, plastic and liquid limit of the soil, and then we can estimate liquidity index. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.